Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanshakaupa Terubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavan Ebyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So, we're going through the fifth canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, and we have come to chapter number 21, about the movement of the sun.
我们继续学习圣典国家网坛第五篇的第21章, 太阳的运行。
Sukadeva Goswami is describing to Maharaj Parikshit about some features of the universe.
Sukadeva Goswami gave Parikshit Maharaj 讲述了这个宇宙的一些特征.
Oh. 对不起, 我的电脑,我需要换电脑, 那个电脑不行, not working. Properly. Just give me a minute. Movements of the sun. Okay, so he describes to us the diameter of the sun, and he explains, he said that the upper portion of the universe can be described by studying the lower portion of the universe, because there are two halves. So if you understand the lower half, you can understand about the size of the upper half.
还是去上锅的。
Oh, wait, sorry, I'm not on Skype yet. I forgot the Skype. Yeah. Yeah. Mm. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Okay.
So it's clear, yeah?
A little noisy.
Ah, a little what?
A little noisy.
Noisy?
Not clear.
Oh. Where's the noise coming from?
No problem, no problem. I can't turn.
Okay, anyway.
Okay.
I was saying,
yes.
The upper portion of the universe can be understood by studying the lower part of the universe.
就是说了解整个宇宙,我们可以通过了解它的下一部分来了解上面这一个部分。
So there's a region between the earth, this earthly planet which we're on, this is the earthly region, and above us is the heavenly region.
在地球领域和天堂领域上面有一个天堂领域.
Right? So that region between the earth and the heaven, that is called Antariksha. Antariksha means outer space.
在地球领域和天堂领域之间的这个部分被称为Antariksha, 被称为外层空间。
So it's between the top part of the earth and the bottom of the heaven.
它连接着地球领域的顶端和天堂领域的底部。
In the middle of that region is the sun, the king of all planets.
在这个领域的中央就是太阳。
So by the influence of the sun, it heats the universe and it helps to keep the order, proper order in the universe.
通过太阳的热量,散发的热量, 能够让整个宇宙维持它的秩序。
Without the light of the sun, we cannot see anything.
而且如果没有太阳的光明的话, 我们什么都看不见。
So, we have to understand that the sun is not staying in one place. The sun also moves, just like the earth moves.
我们可以了解到太阳它也不是说不动的,太阳也在动,地球也是在移动的。
So that sometimes the sun will move slowly, sometimes it will move medium, and sometimes it will go fast, according to the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
有些时候太阳行走的缓慢，有些时候太阳行走的中速，有些时候它行走的迅速，这一切都是在至尊主的命令之上行动的。
And so according to how the sun moves through different parts. Sometimes it's above the equator, and sometimes it's below the equator.
有些时候太阳会在赤道线以上，有些时候太阳会行走到赤道线以下。
Sometimes it comes in touch with the different signs of the zodiac. There's different signs of the zodiac in the year, so that sometimes the sun will come in contact with these different signs.
有些时候太阳也会相应的触及到各种各样的星座。
And this will affect the length of the day and the night.
这就会，而它触及星座也是根据白天和夜晚的这个长短，会影响白天和夜晚的长短。
Just like we know in the winter time, we have longer nights.
就像我们在冬天的时候，我们的白天会非常的短，晚上会非常的长。
But in the summertime, we have longer daytime and short nights.
而在夏天的时候，白天会比较长，夜晚会比较短。So
Lord Brahma, he prays to the he worships Lord Krishna in his Brahma Samhita, and he describes about the sun planet in the Brahma Samhita.
主 Brahma 在他的 Brahma Samhita 中就这样做了一个祈祷，这里面也有关于太阳和至尊主的这个。
It said the sun is considered to be like the eye of the Supreme Lord.
这里描述到太阳可以被形容为是至尊主的眼睛。
And it has a fixed orbit, it moves in a fixed orbit of eternal time.
它稳定地处在至尊主的控制之下。
And it has unlimited potency in terms of heat and light.
它有无限的热量和光芒。
We know that we can depend on the sun. When the sun comes, then there will be light and there will be heat.
我们非常依靠太阳，因为太阳可以给我们光芒，也可以给我们热量。
So the sun is sometimes described as Bhagavan because it's so powerful.
有些时候太阳被称为Bhagavan。
It's the most powerful planet in the universe.
它是这个宇宙之中最有力量的星球。
But it also moves under the order of Govinda Krishna.
但它仍然是在 主狗文档的控制之下。
And he has to move in orbit, has his fixed orbit which he follows. He has to move in that orbit. He cannot go any just where he likes. He has to move exactly according to his direction.
但他必须执行狗文档的训令命令，他不可以偏离任何一寸，所有的地方完全执行狗文档的命令。
Just a minute, I need to put my plug in my computer. No power.
Hare Krishna, Sati Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
您那里听得还行吗？
可以，还可以。
OK, 好。
OK, Okay, so the main point is to understand how the material nature is under the direction of Krishna, Govinda. And the sun is also part of that material nature which is under the control of Govinda.So sometimes you get the duration of the day and the duration of the night may be equal. The day may be as long as the night.
有些时候白天和黑夜的时间是平等的，一样的长。
But other times the day will be longer and the night shorter, and other places the night will be longer and the day shorter.
而其他的时间要么就是白天长一点夜晚短一点，要么就是白天短一点夜晚长一点。
When the sun goes to the south, then the day grows longer.
当太阳向南边运行的时候，白天就会比较长。
And when it travels to the north, then the nights grow longer.
当太阳向北方运行的时候，月晚上又会比较长一点。
So Sukadeva Goswami is describing to Maharaj Parikshit, he said the sun travels over all the sides of this big mountain, Manasotara mountain.
Sukadeva Goswami 就跟 Parikshit 讲，所有的所太阳环绕着这个
Manasotara
山上。
And this mountain is east of Mount Sumeru.
这个山在苏梅鲁山的东面。
And there's a place there called Devadani where King Indra lives.
我补充一下，前面说的就是太阳环绕着 Manasotana 山周围在旅行，而在 Manasotana 山上，苏梅鲁山的正东面是一个叫 Devadani 的地方，由英卓王拥有。
And then to the south, there's a place where Yamaraj lives.
在南面是一个叫 Sanimani 的地方，由 Yamaraj 所拥有。
And then in the west, there's another place where Varuna, the god of the sea, lives.
在西面是一块地方是由 Varuna 所拥有。
And in the north, there's a place where the moon god lives.
而在北面这一块地方被月神所拥有。
So you've got sunrise, you've got midday, you've got sunset.And then you've got midnight. So it happens in these different places according to different times.
因此根据特定的时间，日升、正午、日落、子夜，所有这些在那些地方发生。
Yeah, and according to these different times, then people do different things, we do different activities.
根据特定的时间，所有的生物根据他们根据他们所从事他们赋予的职责，从事各自附近的职责。
You know, when sunrise, then you wake up, sunrise where people are beginning to work, they go to work, they're doing, start their business, go to market, do everything with the sunrise.
就比如说当太阳升起来的时候，人们就会起床，然后再往后面走，人们会去上班，然后到太阳下山的时候，人们就会回来。
Then midday, people will take a break, they may take their food, eat their lunch in the midday.
在中午的时候，人们会吃一点午餐。
And then sunset, they start to put everything away, finish the day, finish the work of the day, pack up.
当太阳落山的时候，人们就把所有的工作都做完了，准备回家，再收拾东西。
And midnight, we hope they're having a good night's rest.
到了晚上的时候，就准备睡觉。
So the people living on Sumeru Mountain, they are always very warm.
因此，在苏梅鲁山上的生物总是感觉到非常的温暖。
Just like at midday, the sun, when the sun's at midday, that's the hottest time of the day.
就像在中午的时候，太阳总是在当空挂着。
So for the people at Sumeru Mountain, the sun is always over their head.
太阳面对着众星座，太阳总是在他们的头顶。
So when the sun travels, we said the sun is always rotating, it travels, so it travels from Devadani, the residence of Indra, and it travels to the residence of Yamaraj.
有些时候太阳会受到Dakshina风的影响。
No, the sun travels from the house of Indra, it goes to the house of Yamaraj. Can you not hear me?
Yeah, always not clear.
The voice breaking or something?
Sati Mataji. Hare Krishna, Sati Mataji. Hare Krishna, Sati Mataji.
Where does she go? She goes off, huh? Anyway, we'll have to continue.
Okay, I try my best.
Unless I just try, wait, let me see, maybe I can do something on system preference. We should look on what? The sound. Yeah, it should be okay. Okay, I don't know. Okay. Anyway, we're hearing about the motion of the sun. The sun moves from the residence of Indra, it goes to the residence of Yamaraj.
Okay. 如果我们看这个太阳的活动的话，它会从这个Indra 的那个地方，然后运行到 Yamaraj 的那个地方。
And it travels that distance in a very short time.
他就这样行为非常非常短的时间。
And then from the residence of Yamaraj, then the sun moves to the residence of Varuna. Haribol? Subhuti?
Haribo? Hare Krishna?
Yeah, Hare Krishna. Can you hear me?
Oh, yes, that's
yeah,
wonderful.
Yes. Yes, very well. No.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Yes. Okay. Very clear, very clear. Thank you.
So we're hearing how the sun moves from Yamaraj's house, it goes to Varuna's house.
我们听到的是太阳从 Yamaraj 的地方到不
Haribol
Hare Krishna, can you say again? 从
It goes from Yamaraj's house, it goes to the house of Varuna.
对，从 Yamaraj 的地方到 Varuna 的地方。
Then it goes to the residence of the moon god.
然后再到了月神的地方。
Then it goes to Indra.
然后再到 Indra 的家。
So in the same way, the moon, along with the other stars and planets, they also become sometimes visible, sometimes invisible.
类似的，月球连同其他的星球们一起在天上。时而有时候是可见的，有时候是不可见的。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says in the 10th chapter, he said, "Of stars, I am the moon."
在《薄伽梵歌》中 ，Krishna 说到，在群星之中，我是月亮。
This means that the moon is like a star; it's not like a sun.
这个说明。月球实际上是星球，它不是它不是月，它不是跟太阳一样。
There's only one sun in the universe.
在整个宇宙之中，只有一个太阳。
Some people think that every star is like a sun.
有一些人认为天空中的这些发光体都是太阳。
But actually, these stars they get their light from the sun.
但事实上，这些发光体它们都是从太阳那里得到光的。
So sometimes you may see some stars in the sky. They're actually they may be from another universe.
有些时候我们也看到在天空中看到一些发光体，或许这些。
I'm trying again.
Okay.
Okay, so we said we can only see what's in this universe. We cannot see beyond the universe.
我们只能看到我们这个宇宙之内的，我们看不到超出这个宇宙之外的东西。
And there's only one sun in each universe.
在每一个宇宙只有一个太阳。
And there's one Brahma also in each universe.
在每个宇宙只有一位主 Brahma.
But of course, there's other demigods, but they're not equal to Brahma.
当然也会有其他的一些半神，但是他们不能和 Brahma 相提并论。
So the chariot of the sun god travels around this. When the sun moves, it's done by the chariot of the sun god.
这个太阳在运行的时候，实际上是太阳神他乘驾着他的马车在行走。
And it's worshipped by the words from the Gayatri Mantra, Om Bhur Bhuvaswa.
而他被受到这个 Gayatri Mantra 中的前面 Om Bhur Bhuvaswa 这几个曼陀罗所崇拜。
And it travels through the four different residences which we mentioned.
太阳神沉降着马车，它会经历过四个居所，这四个居所就是我们之前刚刚提到的那四个居所。
Right, Yamaraj, and the moon god, and the sun god, and Indra, king of heaven.
比如我们前面提到的 Yamaraj, 然后 Indra, 月神以及 Varuna。
So the chariot of the sun god has only one wheel.
太阳神的战车只有一个轮子。
And the 12 months of the year are calculated from the, they're like the spokes of the wheel, which, you know, there's these struts, a piece of the things come from the outside of the wheel to the center of the wheel, that's called a spoke.You see, it holds the wheel together, so there's 12 of those.
就是太阳的战车这个轮子的中间就有那些轮条。而这十二个月就相当于这个轮子的十二根辐条轮条。
And there are six.
中间的那些轴。
There are six seasons.
有六个季节。
At least here in India, you have six seasons.
我们在印度是有六个季节的。
So that's like different parts of the rim of the wheel.
这六个季节是车轴的边缘部分。
And there's also three periods for Chaturmasya.
有三个 Chaturmasya.
Right, 12 months. Each month, there's 4 months in each Chaturmasya.So 3 times 4 is 12, that's 1 year.
一年有十二个月，每一个查图玛夏相当于有四个月，三四四就是一十二。
So these are sections of the hub of the wheel. The hub is there at the center of the wheel.
三个查图玛夏的时期是车轮由三个部分组成的这个骨。
So the chariot, there's one axle, you see one axle, and one side of the axle is resting on Mount Sumeru.
车轮的轴一头搭在苏梅鲁山的山顶。
And the other rests on Manasatara Mountain.
而另一头搭在 Manasatara 山上。
And the wheel continuously rotates on that Manasatara Mountain.
车轮被固定在车轴的这些山上。
Just like if in India in the villages, they want to press oil, and they will have a bull, and they'll have this bull go round and round, and it will turn the wheel to press the oil to take the oil out from the different vegetables.
就像在印度，他们为了榨这个油，会用一个公牛绑着一个车上面这个轮子呢，这个公牛就围绕着这个中间的，就是转，边转的时候，那个车的这个轴就压这个食物，然后这个食物产生这个油。
So the upper end of the upper end of the this.See, the first axle is attached to a second axle.
这第一根车轴连接在第二根车轴上。
And the second axle is attached to Dhruva Loka.
而第二根车轴上一端被拴在朱瓦罗卡上。
And it's attached, they're attached by the rope of wind.
它的这个他们连接是被一根是风的绳子拴在这个朱瓦罗卡上。
So the chariot also has horses.
这个车同样也有马。
And these,
是一辆马车。
These horses are named after Gayatri and other Vedic meters, different meters which are used to chant mantras.
拉着战车的马是以 Gayatri 和其他的伟大音节的名字而形成的。
So this chariot, it always carries the sun god. The sun god's always there on his chariot, going around.
这个战车永恒不停，就是不停地载着 太阳神，太阳神永远都在这个战车之上。
And there's seven horses pulling this chariot of the sun god.
载着太阳神战车的有七匹马。
Oh, could imagine how difficult it is if you have seven horses to pull a chariot.
我们可以想象这是有多么困难的一件事，如果在一个车上有前面有七头马。
But the sun god is so expert, he can control this chariot.
但是太阳神他非常的专业，他可以控制这七匹马。
And then there's a demigod called Aruna, and he sits in front of the sun god, and he's driving the chariot.
在这个战车上有一个半神人叫 Arunadeva。他坐在太阳神的前面，驱赶着这个马车。
And he's controlling the horses.
是他在驾驭着马匹。
And he's always looking back at the sun god.
但是他总是朝后看着太阳神。
So although Runadeva he's in the front seat, and he's controlling the horses, but he always looks back to the sun god.
这个 Arunadeva 虽然在前面坐着控制着马，然后他坐在前面，但是他总是在驾着马车，同时在看着太阳神。
And then there are 60,000 saintly persons.
有六万名的圣人们在这个。
They are called the Valikyas.
他们被称为 Valikyas.
And they're only the size of a thumb.
他们只有这个拇指一样的大小。
And they're also in front of the sun god.
他们也在太阳神的面前。
And they're offering prayers of glorification to the sun god.
他们一直向太阳神供奉着荣耀他的祷文。
And so the Valakyas, they're residents of a higher planet in this universe, you see.
我们可以看到在这个太阳神那里他们是属于这些高等星球的居民。
They're simply persons. They have a lot of punya. That's why they get to do this service.
他们是圣人，所以他们有这个机会去做这样的服务。
Then there are 14 other saints.
还有另外的14位圣人。
There's Gandharvas, who can sing and dance nicely.
他们是 Gandharva, 他们可以唱诵和跳舞非常好。
And then you have Apsaras, there's heavenly women, very beautiful.
还有 Apsara 就是天堂星球那些非常美丽的女子。
And then you have Nagas mean the snakes.
还有 Naga, 那些蛇。
And Yakshas, these people have mystic powers.
Yaksha, 那些人有玄秘力量。
And Rakshasas, these people are flesh eaters.
还有 Rakshasa, 他们是吃血肉的人。
And there's demigods also.
还有半神人。
So they're all there with the sun god.Moving with the sun god.
他们都在那里和太阳一起行动，一起行走。
And as they move, they perform different ceremonies. They perform ritualistic ceremonies to worship the supreme lord.
他们一边运行，一边不断地履行不同的这种仪式和典礼。
They're worshiping the supreme lord, but they're worshiping him through the demigod.Surya Dev, who is the sun god.
他们崇拜 Surya, 崇拜至尊主，但是他们就是把崇拜 Surya Dev 作为至尊主一样去崇拜。
So the demigod, Surya, the sun god, is very powerful. So he's given respect and worship by all of these other people who are from the higher planets.
Surya Dev 非常的有力量，非常强大，因此他受到所有这些圣人们的尊敬和崇拜。
Right, you've got the Gandharvas singing in front of him, and the Apsaras are dancing.
Gandhava 在他们前，在他前面唱歌 ，Apsara 在他在车前面跳舞。
You've got people called the Nishacharas. They follow the chariot. They come behind the chariot.
还有像 Nishacharas， 他在追随着战车。
And then you've got people called the Panagas. They decorate the chariot.
还有叫 Panagas， 他们在装饰着这个战车。
And the Yakshas they guard the chariot.
还有 Yaksha 是他护卫着战车。
And those 60,000 Valikiyas who are just the size of a thumb, they are offering the prayers.
总共有这么多人，他们都
环
绕着太阳神。
有六万 Valikiyas.
有六万 Valikiyas， 他们环绕着太阳神，献上祷文。
And these different groups, they arrange the proper time for, snow and rain and heat in the universe.
有不同的人，他们在有规律的在整个宇宙下雪，给予这个宇宙温暖，降雨等等。
So the sun, and the sun makes this orbit through Bhumandala. Our Earth planet is in Bhumandala.And the sun traverses, it moves around in a very short time.
这个地球被称为 Bhumandala， 然后太阳在这个地球的这个轨道上只花了一点点的时间。
Okay, so we'll go ahead on to the next chapter, the orbits of the planets.
好，我们进入到下面一章，众星球的轨道。
So Maharaj Parikshit tells Sukadeva Goswami that you've told us about the sun and how it travels around Dhruvaloka.
Maharaj Parikshit Wang 询问 Sukadeva Goswami， 你现在你描述了太阳是如何围绕着 Dhruvaloka 运行的。
But he always keeps Dhruvaloka and Mount Sumeru on his right.That's out of respect for Dhruvaloka and Mount Sumeru. Although he's traveling around, he always keeps Dhruvaloka and Mount Sumeru on his right.
太阳在运行的时候，朱瓦洛卡和苏梅鲁山总是在太阳神的右侧，因为他们总是给予太阳神尊敬。
But at the same time, somehow he keeps Mount Sumeru and Dhruvaloka on his left.
但有些时候。他会让这个苏梅鲁山和朱瓦洛卡又在他的左侧。
So Maharaj Parikshit wants to know, how can we understand that the sun god has Sumeru and Dhruvaloka on both his left side and right side at the same time?
因此 ，Maharaj Parikshit 王的问题是，如何？这是如何发生的呢？就是当太阳神在前进的时候，苏梅鲁山和朱瓦洛卡。为什么同时又在他的左侧，又在他的右侧，同时能够在他们的两侧呢
？So Sukadeva Goswami gives a nice answer.
因此 ，Sukadeva Goswami 给了一个非常好的回答。
He gives an example. He said, just like when a potter he has a wheel, and he uses the potter's wheel is used to carve different things like bowls and cups and vessels.So the wheel was moving around, and little insects, little ants, may be on the wheel, and they move with it.
Sukadeva Goswami 清晰地回答：当一个陶工的轮子在转动时，处在大轮子上的小蚂蚁们和轮子就会一起转动。
So although the little insects are moving with it.Their motion is different from that of the wheel.
虽然这些小虫子、小蚂蚁们的运动方式不同于这个轮子的运动，但是它们看上去时就是在轮子的一侧。
Sometimes they appear on one part of the wheel, and sometimes they appear on another part of the wheel.
有些时候。 这些蚂蚁看上去在轮子的一侧，有些时候又在另外一侧。
So in the same way, you have Sumeru and Dhruvaloka on the right, and they're moving with the wheel of time.
同样的道理，苏梅鲁山和朱瓦洛卡和时间之轮一同转动。
And then you have the sun is like the ant. The sun is like the insect, the ant on the wheel. The sun and the other planets, they're moving with them, but they're independent.
这个太阳就像这些蚂蚁，它们都在这个时间之轮上一起运动。
So you can see the sun and the planets, they're seen in different places at different times.
我们可以看到太阳和这些星球们在不同的时间的不同的位置。
So the motion of the sun and the different planets is different from the wheel of time.
这表明它们的运动不同于时间之轮本身的运动。
The original cause of the whole creation is the Supreme Lord Narayan.
而至尊的这个源头是至尊主 Narayana.
And when saintly persons who know Vedic knowledge, when they offer prayers to the Supreme Lord, then he comes to the material world in the form of the sun.
当精通伟达知识的这些圣人们向至尊主献上祷文时，这个至尊主就会以太阳的形体降临这个物质世界。
And in the form of the sun, he gives benefit to all the planets, and he purifies everybody's activities.
当至尊主以太阳的形体降临到这个地球时，他会净化所有的活动。
But he also creates the different seasons, and he divides the year into different parts.
当然，他也把自己分成这些不同的部分，创造不同的季节。
He arranges for the different qualities like heat and cold.
而且他也创造了这些季节的不同的品质，比如说冷和热等等。
So according to people's position in the Vana and Ashrams, people will worship the Supreme Lord Narayan.
根据人们的 Vana 和 Ashram 的这个制度，人们来崇拜这个太阳神。
And they will worship him as the sun god.
他们崇拜他就像太阳神一样。
And they may worship him also as the super soul.Within the heart of all living entities.
人们崇拜他也把至尊主当作，也把他当作人内心的这个所有生物体心中的超灵的形式去崇拜他。
And they may also do different sacrifices, like Agnihotri sacrifice.
他们也会做不同的仪式和祭祀，比如 Agnihotri火祭。
Or they may practice mystic yoga.
或者他们会从事一些玄秘瑜伽。
And in this way, they can get the goal of life.
这样他们可以达到生命的目标。
So the sun god is situated in outer space, right? Between the heavenly planets and the earthly planets.
太阳神是在外层空间，它是在地球和这个上面的中间的那个部分。
So sometimes in the course of a month, we will see also there's different conditions of the moon. Sometimes the moon is getting bigger, sometimes it's getting smaller.
当太阳运行的时候，这个月亮也会有不同的变化。有时候这个月亮会比较大一点，有时候月亮会比较小一点。
And according to calculation, a month equals 2 1/4 movements of the stars.
根据计算，一个月又等于二又四分之一的这个星座。
Every 2 months, you get a new season.
每两个月就会得，就会有一个新的季节。
So these different seasons are like parts of the body of the year.
这个季节又是被誉为这个一年的这个躯体的各个部分。
Then Sukadeva Goswami described, he said, the sun god has three speeds, slow, fast, and average.
Sukadeva Goswami 描述到太阳神有三个速度，慢速、快速和中速。
So the time it takes to travel around the different spheres, around heaven and earth,The time it takes to travel is known by different names.
而太阳神以这三种速度环绕着天堂、地球和外层空间，它们运行的速度，这个时间有不同的名字。
So we can see in the calendar, you get different calculations. You get.The calendar for the sun is different from the calendar for the moon.
就是说我们的这个计算，比如说阳历就比阴历的这个时间是不一样的。
Just like, you see, sometimes we have Purushottam Mass, we have an extra month every 3-4 years, right? We get the Purushottam Mass every 3 years.
比如说我们的这个 Purushottam Month, Purushottam 月每三到四年就会有一个多出来的一个 Purushottama 月。
And in the solar calendar, you have things like you have leap years, you have a leap year, and you have every 4 years you have a leap year, 28 days in ordinary in February, but 29 in a leap year.
就像每20年或者是21年，在二月份的时候。这个有些时候是
There's a leap year, a thing called a leap year. It means every 4 years, you have a leap year. In February has 28 days, but in the leap year, there will be 29 days.
在这个闰的时候，每四到五，在二月的时候，比如说通常是28。但是在那个特殊的年份的时候，就会有29天。
And we see all the months in our solar calendar, they have different lengths. Some months are 30 days and some months are 31 days.
再比如说我们的月份，有些月份是30天，有些月份是31天。
So in the Vedic calendar, you don't have it like that. You have all the months the same.
但是在伟达的这个日历上，我们不是这样计算的。伟达日历上每个月都是一样长的。
So then Sukadeva Goswami goes on to describe about how the rays of the sun, above the rays of the sun is a moon.
Sukadeva Goswami 继续描述着，在月球的旅行速度是比太阳要快的。
And the sun.The moon travels at a speed faster than the sun.
月球的旅行速度比太阳快，在太阳光线之上是月球。
So from the Srimad Bhagavatam, we understand how.The sun is actually nearer to the planet Earth than the moon.
从圣典波迦瓦坛我们可以了解到，实际上太阳离地球更近一些，月球离地球要远一些。
Because from this information, we find out how the moon is actually very far away from the Earth planet.
从这些信息我们可以了解到，月球离地球非常非常的遥远。
But still, they claim that they'd gone to the moon.
但是仍然有很多人，有人在宣称他们去过月球。
And the modern scientists, they think the moon is nearer to the earth than the sun.
现代科学家们计算出月球离地球要更近一些。
But we don't accept what modern science say. Modern science, they're always changing their opinions. They have many different theories.
但是我们并不接受这些现代科学家们的说法，因为他们的说法总是在不断的变化。
They had so many different theories in the beginning. Oh well, and when they try to explain life, they have many different theories.
他们有很多不同的理论，他们也想解释。他们有很多不同的理论。
So we don't accept their theories. We follow the Vedas.
我们不接受他们的理论，我们认可的是《韦达经》。
We don't take their speculative knowledge. We take evidence based on Shastra.
我们不接受他们思辨出来的知识，我们来接受经典所给予我们的知识。
And everything in the Vedas, everything in the scriptures can be confirmed by calculation. As you can do the calculation, you can confirm everything.
而伟达经的所有的这一切都可以被证明，都可以被计算出来。
Even people do astrology, they can calculate everything, they can do everything with the science of astrology. They know the motions of the planets, where they're all moving, how they're moving.
人们如果懂这个天文学的话，他们可以计算，他们可以知道这些月球、这些星球是怎么样行动的。
So people are often surprised how it is the Vedas can give so much knowledge which other people don't know.
人们也非常的惊讶，为什么这个韦达经可以给出我们这么多的知识，而在其他的学科里面并没有给我们。
Because this Vedic knowledge is coming down.Through saintly persons who are not motivated with material desires.
因为这些伟达经，它是从圣人那里面传下来的，而这些圣人是不受这些物质自然属性的影响的。
Okay, so Sukadeva Goswami is describing about the moon. He says, so when the moon is waxing, then the bright portion increases.Right, the waxing means it's getting bigger. So the bright part of the moon is increasing every day.
当这个月亮逐渐的变圆时，就是越来越大时，变圆时，它发光的部分日益增加。
And this means this is like daytime for the demigods, and it's nighttime for the pitas.
这是半神人们的白天，而对于毗塔们是他们的夜晚。
But when the moon is waning, when it's getting smaller, then this is night for the demigods, and this is daytime for the pitas.
当月亮就是变得越来越小的时候，这个时候是太阳月半神们的夜晚，是毗塔们的白天。
So in this way, the moon passes through one day. In one day of time, the moon passes through a constellation.
就这样，月球在一整天之内经过，一整天之内经过每一个星座。
So the moon is very important. It has a very important effect on the food that we grow.
月球它能影响食物的生长。
Because the rays of the moon, they give special taste to the vegetables.
月亮的升起，它能够给这些蔬菜以特别的滋味。
And from the moon, there's a special coolness. You know, from the sun you get heat, but from the moon, there's a coolness. The moon is cooling.After the heat of the day, the rays of the moon are cooling, and this influences the growth of the grains that we grow in the fields.
就是在白天一整天被太阳晒过之后，热量接受到热量之后，在晚上，月亮它给我们的是清凉的这种感受，而这个是这个 对于这个谷物生长非常非常的重要。
This is also mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita in the 15th chapter.
这也在博迦梵歌中的第十五章被描述。
How Krishna gives the taste of he puts the juice into the vegetables and the grains that we grow through the moon.
通过月亮，我给予所有的植物以滋味。
So because the moon is doing this, the moon is like the life. It gives life to all the living entities.
因为月亮有这样的功能，它所以被认为是所有众生的生命。
So he's given the name Jiva, the living, chief living being within the universe.
因此，它也被称为 Jiva, 这个宇宙中的首要生物。
So the moon also represents.The influence of Krishna, on the Supreme Lord.
月球也代表着至尊人格守神的至尊主的影响力。
And the moon is the deity. The moon is the actually the deity in everyone's mind.
月球也是每个人心意的主宰神。
So the moon god gets the name Manomaya.Manomaya, mana is the mind, Maya, the one who controls the mind, the energy of the mind.
因此，月神也被称为 Manomaya, 他能够控制一个人的心意。
And he also, the moon god is also sometimes called Anamaya, because he gives potency to so many different herbs and plants.
月神也被称为 Anamaya, 因为他给予所有草药和植物能力。
And he's called also Amritamaya, because he gives life to living entities.
他也被称为 Amritamaya, 因为他是所有生物的生命源泉。
Amrita means who does not die, one who is eternal.
Amrita 意思是不死的，永恒的。
So the moon god pleases the demigods. He pleases the demigods and the pitas and the human beings. He pleases the animals and the birds.
月神他取悦了人们、半神人、pita、人类，还有这些动物、鸟类、植物等等。
He gives pleasure to all the trees and the plants, to all the living entities.
他也取悦所有这些树木、植物，还有所有的其他生物。
Everyone is satisfied by the moon.
每一个生物都因月球的存在而感到满足。
So the moon is also called Sarvamaya, all-pervading.
因此，月球也被称为 Sarvamaya, 遍存万有的。
And there are many stars also above the moon.
也有很多的星星位于月球之上。
And they're also under the control of the Supreme Lord.
这一切也在至尊人格、至尊主的控制之下。
They're fixed to the wheel of time.
他们被固定在时间之轮上。
And they rotate, but they keep Mount Sumeru on their right.
他们也在旋转，苏梅鲁山在其右侧。
So there are 28 important stars.
总共有28颗首要的星星。
And the main star is called Abhijit.
主要的这个星星是 Abhijit.
Okay, so we'll stop here.
好，我们停在这儿。
We'll hear about the other stars.About the rest of the universe in the future.
后面我们会讲这个其他的星星。
Are there any questions?
Not yet.
我们暂时还没有问题，我们稍等一下。
Okay, so there's 1,600,000 miles above the stars.Is the planet Venus?
在所有这些星星之上的160万英里的地方是金星。
And Venus moves at the same speed as the sun.
金星的运行速度和太阳几乎是一样的。
Sometimes fast, sometimes slow.
有些时候是快的，有些时候是慢的。
Sometimes Venus is in front of the sun, sometimes behind.
有时候金星在太阳后面运动，有时候金星在太阳前面运动。
And Venus has the effect that it takes away the influence of the planets which stop the rain.
金星抵消了作为降雨障碍的星球的影响。
So the presence of Venus that can cause rain.
因此，金星的存在它引起降雨。
So that's very good for people in the universe because they need rain. We need rain to produce vegetables, to grow crops, to produce grains.
因此，它被认为对这个宇宙非常的有利，因为我们需要降水，这些生物也需，这些谷物都需要水。
And Mercury is also similar to Venus.
水星也非常类似于金星。
And sometimes behind the sun, sometimes in front.
有时候它在太阳的前面，有时候它在太阳的后面。
And Mercury is the sun, is the S-O-N, the moon is the father, and Mercury is like the sun of the moon.
水星像好像就水星像是月球的儿子。
And it's also very auspicious, very good for the universe.
水星对于整个宇宙的居民来说也非常的吉祥。
When he doesn't move along with the sun, then he stops cyclones, and he stops dust, and he stops a lot of irregular rainfall.
当水星不跟太阳一起运动时，这个地球上，这个星球上就会有旋风、尘土和不规则的降雨。
Oh yeah, it forebodes cyclones, so that.When it doesn't move along with the sun, then this is when you get these things like cyclones and rainfall at the wrong time and inauspicious things happening.
就是当水星不跟太阳一起运动时，就会有这些没有雨水的云朵，就会有这些不吉祥的事情出现。
So sometimes you get too much rain. That's also due to Mercury not being with the sun.
有些时候，如果有太多的降水，也是由于水星的影响。
Above Mercury is the planet Mars.
在水星上面有火星。
So if this planet doesn't travel in a crooked way, then it crosses through the signs of the zodiac, and it travels through all 12, one after another. This Mars always creates unfavorable conditions in the rain and other influences. It's not very good. It gives a lot of trouble.
当火星以一种不弯曲以一种弯曲的路线旅行的时候，它经过这些星座的时候，它就会带来很多不好的不吉祥的状况的发生，它总是会影响这些星座的发生。
Then above Mars is the planet Jupiter.
在火星之外是金星。
So this planet Jupiter can be very favorable to the Brahmanas in the universe.
金星对于整个宇宙和 Brahmana 是非常有利的。是木星还是木星？
So you can see some planets are good, some planets are not good. Some are auspicious, some are inauspicious.
所以我们看到有些时候是吉祥的，有些时候是不吉祥的。
Then you've got a planet called Saturn, which is very inauspicious.
在木星上面之上是土星，不是很吉祥。
very inauspicious.
它非常的不吉祥。
Creates a lot of problems in the universe.
它给这个宇宙带来很多的麻烦。
And then above Saturn are the seven great saintly sages.
在这个土星上面是七大圣者。
And they're always thinking to how to help the people in the universe.
他们总是想着如何帮助这个宇宙上的众生。
And they always circumambulate Dhruvaloka, the pole star.
他们环绕着被称朱瓦洛卡的这个星球。
Because they know that's the place of Lord Vishnu.
因为他们知道这个是主威士努所在的地方。
So Lord Vishnu, he has taken the form of Sumeru, the mountain Sumeru.
主威士努在苏美如，主 Lord Vishnu form in Sumeru.
Yeah, he's taken the form. Lord Vishnu appears in the form of Sumeru mountain.
主威士努以苏美如山的这个形象显现。
And all the other planets, beginning with the sun, they're under the shelter of this Sumeru planetary system.
而所有的其他这些星系都是在 Sumeru 山的庇护之下运行。
So we're going to hear about Sumeru planets in the next class.
下一节课我们将会听到 Sumeru 的这些星系。
Okay, so we will stop here now.
好，我们讲到这儿。
Any question?
No.
I think because there's the Govardhan retreat is going on, right? Everybody's listening
yeah.
to that.
Yes.
Yes.
但是我们现在也有90多个人在线聆听，97个人。
Oh, 那么多。
哦，有问题了。
So of course,
第一个问题来自于Chandra Vinasi Mataji， 顶拜咕噜甜美的莲花组，请教咕噜的，我们遇到不吉祥的星星，如土星时，怎么做比较好呢？感恩咕噜的仁慈。So when we meet obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, when we meet some inauspicious stars, like Saturn, how we do? What we can do?
We can take shelter of the Supreme Lord Krishna.
我们可以托庇于至尊主 Krishna.
Because all of these planets, they're under the control of the Supreme Lord.
因为所有的这些星系都是在至尊主的控制之下。
And if we've surrendered fully to the Supreme Lord, then these planets, even though they're very, can be very inauspicious, they cannot do us any harm.
因为如果我们全然的托庇于至尊主的话，这些星系即便它不吉祥，它不会对我们造成有任何的伤害。
So as soon as we remember Lord Krishna,then all the inauspicious influences will all be taken, they'll all be overcome.
当我们全然的托庇于 Krishna 的时候，所有这些不吉祥的东西我们都可以跨越过去。
We just have to remember the Supreme Lord, Krishna. We said the material nature moves under his direction.
我们只需要记住至尊主 Krishna, 因为所记忆至尊主 Krishna， 因为所有的物质自然都是在他的指挥之下运作。
So devotee doesn't worry about this planet or that planet. The devotee just takes shelter of Lord Krishna.
奉献者不会担心这个星球那个星系的影响。奉献者只是崇拜 Krishna.
And that means fixing our mind on Krishna, engaging in his service, using body, mind, and words fully in the service of Krishna.
这意味着我们把我们的心专注于 Krishna， 用我们的身体、心意、言语从事于对 Krishna 的服务之中。
So we have to hear about Krishna. We have to chant the glories of Krishna. We have to just surrender to Krishna.
因此，我们得聆听 Krishna， 我们得唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀。我们得唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀。
Srila Vyasadeva was meditating after he got instruction from Narada Muni. Then he sat in meditation and he fixed his mind on the Supreme Lord.
圣维亚萨德瓦在得到南尔达穆尼的训示之后，他开始冥想。他把他的心意完全专注于至尊主的莲花宗。
And he saw the Supreme Lord, and he saw that all the energies of the Lord, they were all under the control of the Supreme Lord.
他那个时候他冥想到所有的这些能量全部都在至尊主的控制之下。
That this material energy was fully under the control of the Supreme Lord.
物质能量完全的处在至尊主的控制之下。
So we hear, oh, Saturn is very inauspicious. Oh, I'm in a Saturn period. Saturn is influencing me, but it doesn't influence us if we're in Krishna consciousness.
我们或许会感觉说，哦，这个土星对我们会有影响，非常的不吉祥。但是如果我们全然的具有 Krishna 知觉的话，它不会影响我们。
Some people, they have these excuses that, oh, I'm in my Saturn period, so this is why I'm very fallen, I'm very lusty just now, because I'm in my Saturn period. But the real solution is to take shelter of Krishna.
有些人会找一个借口说，我最近处在土星的控制之下，所以我最近非常的堕落，非常的色欲，非常的等等的不好。但实际上，真正的解决办法是我们应该托庇于 Krishna。
So by engaging in devotional service, we immediately come to the transcendental level. The transcendental level is not under the influence of auspicious or inauspicious planets.
通过从事奉献服务，通过托庇于 Krishna， 我们会达到一种超人的这个层面。在超人的层面是不会受到物质这些属性的影响。
So we simply train ourselves, train our mind to come to Krishna consciousness, to remember Krishna.
我们只是简简单单的训练我们自己，训练我们的心意，让我们专注于 Krishna， 让我们 fix our mind on Krishna and
don't doubt the power of the holy name. The holy name will remove all the obstacles.
不要怀疑圣名的力量，圣名的力量可以超越一切障碍。
So we encourage we don't encourage people to go to the astrologers and just find out what your chart is like and which planets are a problem for you. You don't have to worry about that. You just have to surrender to Krishna.
我们不鼓励奉献者去这个星象师那里，你现在处于什么星座，处于什么样的这个时期或状态。我们鼓励奉献者是去全然的臣服于 Krishna.
Now there are some devotees who, you know, they dabble in astrology, and they, you know, they make their charts and they find out which planet is influencing them and what is the bad time and what is the good time in their life.
有一些奉献者他在做着这样的事情，比如说他会找到这个图表，找到。计算出他的这个星盘，然后找到他生命中哪个时间是不好的，哪个时间是很好的。
But that's for material life. That's not for spiritual life. So you have to decide: are you going to practice spiritual life or material life?
但那个是针对物质生活的。我不是针对灵性生活的，所以你应该做出选择，你是要想着物质的生活，还是应该朝着灵性的生活走呢？
Yeah, we have the choice. Which way we want to, you know, what kind, How do you want to live? Are you going to live in Krishna consciousness? Are you going to live in bodily consciousness?
我们有我们自己的选择权。你是想继续有这种躯体化的概念呢，还是想拥有 Krishna 知觉的概念呢？
We have that independence. We have that free will as living entities. Krishna's marginal potency.
我们有我们的自由意志和自由意愿。这是 Krishna 给予我们的一个很微小的力量。
Of course, for some people who are not devotees, who don't chant, who don't follow regulative principles, then they have to think about these planets, they have to worry about these things.
对于那些非奉献者，他们并不唱诵的这些人，他们或许可以去考虑，去担心这些事情。
But for someone who is regularly engaging in devotional service, the effects of these planets is not going to be significant. It won't have any real significant effect.
但对于规律的从事奉献服务的这些奉献者来说，这些影响对于他们来说微乎其微。
Krishna explains in the Bhagavad Gita, Mahatmanastu Mamparta Daivim Prakritim Ashrita Bhajantyananya Manaso Gyarvabhuta Dimavyayam. The Mahatmas, the great souls, meaning devotees, are under the protection of the divine energy because they are fully engaged in my devotional service.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中讲到，那些伟大的灵魂在我的至尊能量的控制之下，因为他们恒常从事着对我的奉献服务。
So this is how we get free from these obstacles like inauspicious planets troubling us.
这就是我们超越这些障碍的方法，克服这些障碍的方法。
We simply take shelter of Krishna.
我们只是简单的托庇于 Krishna 就行。
So Prabhupada was describing, he said one time in India,He said there was a great famine. There was no food. You know, the price of rice went up very high.
圣帕帕德讲了一个故事，就是这个农民他没有食物，但是外面的这个粮食的价格又非常的高。
You don't know what famine is? Famine.
Famine.
Famine, they're not able to produce food. It's 一种灾难。灾难。
一种灾难。
There's no food.
就是在那。Sorry. 就是这个灾难来的时候，他们没法种食物，而且食物的价格很高。
But Prabhupada said,somehow he would, when he talked to devotees, he'd ask them, are you okay? Do you have food? Every devotee said, yeah, by the grace of Krishna, we're okay, we're managing.
在那个时候，帕帕就担心这些奉献者们，然后就问奉献者，你们有食物吗？然后这些奉献者说，是的，我们有食物。由于 Krishna 的仁慈，我们有食物。
And we see here in the world, you know, in the last year, we've had this COVID.We've had so many things happen on the planet this year, with this virus, ugly virus going around, troubling everyone. But most devotees have been able to be okay. They've managed to survive. Of course, some devotees left, but that's inevitable. That's not karma. It's Krishna's plan.
我们知道在去年和今年这个新冠病毒确实在全世界肆虐比较严重，但是大多数的奉献者并没有受到其中的一些影响，当然有那么一些的奉献者，有几个奉献者确实离开了，但是他们并不是他们的业报而离开，而是 Krishna 的意愿带着他们离开。
Devotees are not under the laws of karma.
奉献者不在这个业报范围之内。
We're directly under the care of Krishna.
我们直接在 Krishna 的照顾和管辖之下。
Of course, we know. Just last night, they announced that His Holiness Srila Jayapataka Maharaj has been infected with the virus.
就像我们昨天晚上听到 Jayapataka Swami Maharaj, 他也被这个新冠感染。
But we should understand that his getting the disease is not like other people getting the disease.
但是我们需要理解的是，他被感染这个病毒跟其他人感染是不一样的。
Because he's directly under the protection of Krishna.
他是在圣主 Krishna 的直接的保护之下。
So you will say, then why didn't Krishna protect him? Why did he get this? Why did he get?
那你或许会问，为什么 Krishna 没有保护他？为什么他会这样呢？
So Krishna is teaching us we have to take more care of him. We have to protect him better.
这是 Krishna 想要告诉我们，我们得更加照顾他，我们得更加的照顾他。
Krishna may sometimes.We see Krishna arranges for his devotees to be put into these difficulties just to show their devotion.
有些时候，一些奉献者被 Krishna 处于困境之中，只是为了展示这种奉爱。
To show how they respond to the difficulties.
为了展示这些奉献者他们是如何面对这些困难的。
Because difficulties are there for everyone, but the difficulties for a devotee are there. The devotees show the other devotees how to accept these difficulties.
因为困难其实是对每一个人存在的，而困难给予奉献者的意义是，这个奉献者面对困难，他可以向别人展示他是如何面对困难的。
Just like Draupadi, she was put through a test. She was lost in the gambling match, and they tried to disrobe her.
就像 Draupadi, 她也面对的困难。她在这个赌博的这个，她在家人赌博的这个游戏中被就失去了。
But she became more glorious. She was not humiliated. They thought.The sons of Dhritarashtra thought they would humiliate her, but she became more glorious.
这个 Dhritarashtra 的儿子们，他们会认为这个 Draupadi 将会被玷污，但是呢，她实际上在这个事件之后被更加的荣耀了。
She showed her greatness and she showed her purity.
她展示了她的伟大和纯洁。
And she showed how to take shelter of Lord Krishna.
她展示了如何托庇于 Krishna.
Any other question?
Yeah. Next question from Draupadi Maharaj. 感恩 Guru 讲述这么不可思议的科学知识。所谓的现代科学与伟达知识差得太远。那我们如何能让他们幸福呢？Since gurus give us inconceivable knowledge, nowadays the modern science knowledge is far from the Vedic knowledge. So how can we let the other people have the confidence of the Vedic knowledge?
We have to show how nice and how successful our life becomes by applying this Vedic knowledge.
我们通过向别人展示我们在应用这个伟大知识的我们自己的这一生在应用这个伟大知识的成功的程度来让别人信服这个伟大知识。
Yeah, we should show the ideal character, the ideal behavior.We should show ideal family life.
我们得展示理想的品质， 理想的生活，理想的家居生活。
嗯，那 and you should have perfect dealings with your husband and with your bring up your child to be a very nice, wonderful child.
比如说你和你的家人处理的关系非常好，你生育的孩子，你养育你的孩子也非常的好，你和你的先生的关系也处理得非常好。
Keep your child healthy and happy.
能够让你的孩让你的孩子保持健康和快乐。
If you bring your child up to be a nice devotee.
让你的孩子把你的孩子抚养成一个很好的奉献者。
Means the child will develop all the good qualities of the devotee.
这也意味着你的孩子在发展的在成长的同时能够发展出奉献者的所有这些美好的品质。
And people will appreciate that, oh, your child is so very nice, very good qualities.
这样人们就会欣赏你的孩子，哦，你的孩子长得也非常好，而且有非常多美好的品质。
And your home should be always clean and tidy.
你的家庭也非常的干净和整洁。
And you should cook nice food to feed your husband and child.
你也应该给你的丈夫和孩子烹饪非常美味的食物。
So people will know that your life is very good. You're very happy together. You're very joyful and peaceful. You do everything very nicely.
这样人们就会觉得你的生活非常的美好，你的家庭都非常的美好，你的生活也非常的美好。
You don't eat meat. You don't smoke and drink alcohol. You don't have any bad habits.
你不吃鱼肉蛋，你没有这些不好的行为。
So this way you show the value of Vedic knowledge.
以此这样的方式你展示了伟达知识的价值。
Srila Prabhupada also began the Bhaktivedanta Institute, which was for scientists, people who had a good science education, that they could go and preach to other scientists and convince them about the Vedic knowledge.
Srila Prabhupada 在开始这个 Bhaktivedanta 学院的时候，他也非常是以科学的方式为开始的。他希望人们了解科学，然后向这些科学家们能够去传播，传播 Krishna 知觉。
Yeah, the main preaching was that life does not come from chemicals.
最主要的传播的第一条传教是。向他们最主要传播的第一条是生命并不来自于化学。
But life has to come from life, not from dull matter.
生命是来自于生命，而不是来自于这些迟钝的物质。
So materialistic scientists, they have many misconceptions, and that was a big misconception which Srila Prabhupada was very concerned about.
这些物质主义科学家有非常多非常错误的概念，圣帕帕德也非常关心这一点。
As you have heard today, you know, the scientists, they often think there's more than one sun in the universe. They think the moon is also like a sun.
就像现在我们经常听到的这些科学家们说，不只有一个太阳，而且这个月亮也是太阳，所有这些星星也是太阳。
We say the moon is a reflection of the light of the sun.
我们说月亮是来自于太阳的发光。
And they say that the moon is nearer to the earth than the sun. We don't agree with that.
他们还说月球离地球近，但是我们并不同意这一点。
We see, you know, the Americans say they went to the moon.But they never went again.
我们还听到这些美国人说他们去过月球，但是他们再也去不了了，他们再也没有去过了。
So it's very doubtful that they actually went to the moon.
这些都是值得怀疑的，他们是不是真的去了月球，这都值得怀疑。
It's just big propaganda cheating.
这是一个很大的欺骗。
Trick the whole world.
欺骗了整个世界。
So science is full of that. A lot of cheating goes on in the name of science.
很多的欺骗都，很多的科学里面都有，就是科学里面包含了很多的欺骗，这些欺骗被冠以科学的名义。
Fake results, they do experiments and the results are not genuine, they just make up the results, no real proof.
他们去做很多的实验，但是这个结果并不能被证明。
Very hard.
非常难。
Science, you see, scientists, they're the Brahmanas of today, because the science influence how people think.
这些科学家们就像当今的婆罗门 Brahmana, 因为他们深刻地影响着人们的行为。
So the scientists, they have a big position in the world because they're thinking, they're controlling how people think.
因此他们在，这些科学家们在当今有很大的地位，因为他们完全控制着人们的思想。
We can see, you know, we're giving class, we're using so much technology. We're using this internet and Skype and everything. It's all using a lot of scientific innovations.
就像我们今天讲这个课，我们也运用了很多的高科技的这些知识，这些技术，这些我们运用了很多的这些技术，
so、probably,
比如说因特网等等。
Prabhupada wanted us to use technology. He said you have to keep up with technology. You can't just stand and let it go on and not. You have to keep up with the technology.
圣帕帕德也希望我们运用这些知识，而不只是站在一边。我们应该应用这些技术。
We don't like it, but we have to use it.
我们不应该去喜欢它，但是我们需要用它。
Because we have to use it for the service of Krishna, because the whole world is using it.
因为整个世界都在用它，我们要用这些高科技来服务 Krishna.
And by the use of this technology, we can contact so many places, meet so many people who would never normally be possible.
我们运用这些高科技可以和很多世界上其他的人得以建立连接，这在以前是很不可能的。
But we don't get overly attached to the whole thing. We understand this is all just Krishna's illusory energy.
我们不应该太依附于这些高科技，因为这些高科技只是 Krishna 的这个虚幻能量而已。
We don't want this technology to come between us and Krishna.
我们不希望这些高科技是我们和 Krishna 之间的这个中间的这个障碍。
We want to wake up in the morning to think to go to Arti, to go to Mangal Arti. We don't just wake up to see our handphone.
我们起来应该早上先去见蒙哥阿提，先去蒙哥阿提。我们不要一起来就去看我们的手机。
Okay, any other question?
Yes.Next from Radhisham Madhaji, 顶拜 Guru Day, 顶拜翻译。遇到物质的节日，物质主义者杀生太多的，我会躯体非常不舒服。明明没有生病，但觉得自己病得很重，怎么办 ？Obeisance to Guru Day. There are many material festivals, and these materialist people killing so many animals.So when these material festivals, I feel my body are very uncomfortable, but not here. But I feel I get very heavy sick. How to do?
Well, keep away from these kind of festivals. Don't get involved. Don't have anything to do with these kind of festivals.We have our own festivals. We have our pure Mother Goodness festivals, Krishna conscious festivals.
远离这些物质的节日，不要陷入这些物质的节日，不要在这个物质节日做这些什么，跟着他们一起进去。我们有我们自己的 Krishna 知觉的很善良形态的这些节日。
Yeah, we want to teach people. We like festivals. We want to make festivals every day, but the festivals have to be in pure goodness.
我们得告诉人们，我们是喜欢节日的。我们但是我们喜欢的这些，我们所有的这些节日都是非常纯粹的善良心态的。
We want to introduce people to Krishna Prasadam and let them be happy taking Prasadam and chanting the holy name of Krishna.
我们邀请这些人们来品尝 Krishna 的 Prasadam， 来在 Krishna 的圣名之中跳舞。
So we want to see devotees in China making very nice tasty prasadam, and then they'll be really happy, they will enjoy.
我们希望中国的奉献者能够做非常美味的 prasadam， 这样他们就会非常的享受，非常的喜欢。
I was speaking to one devotee last night, and he was telling me, he said, when I went to Mayapur, we had so many nice things to eat. He said, I always remember all the tasty things I had to eat in Mayapur.
昨天晚上有一个奉献者跟我说，我总是在想着，每当我去到玛雅普的时候，玛雅普有那么多美味的东西可以吃。
And yesterday I was invited to the Gurukula, where the young boys, where there's 60 young boys staying in the traditional Gurukula.
昨天我被邀请到去到 Gurukula， Gurukula 那里有60个小孩在那里接受训练。
And they grow all their own vegetables and fruits.
那里种了很各种各样的水果和蔬菜。
And they also grow their own rice.
他们也种植自己的大米。
So they're 85% self-sufficient.
85%的东西他们都可以自给自足。
Just a few things they get from outside.
他们只从外面拿有一部分的东西从外面获得。
So they had a festival. They brought all the Prabhupada disciples there yesterday, and they fed lunch to them.
他们邀请了帕帕所有的门徒，然后给他们大餐。
And the prasadam was so good. It was so tasty.
昨天的这个 prasadam 非常的好，非常的美味。
They cooked so many nice vegetables, and then they had sweets also.
他们做了很多的蔬菜，然后还有很多的水，很多的甜点。
And they cook it all themselves.
而且这全都是他们自己做的。
And so they're showing how to have a festival in pure goodness.
他们向我们展示了如何做一个就是纯粹善良属性的节日的这些活动。
If the material world people have horrible festivals,
这些物质主义者的这些人们，他们的这个节日实在是太可怕。
Yeah, they have things like dead fish, dead animals.
他们吃这些死鱼、死的动物。
And then they have the fermented.Liquids, beer, and alcohol, wine, and all horrible intoxication things.
他们还喝那些各种各样的麻醉品的饮料，啤酒、白酒、酒精等等。
And they are thinking very nice festival.
而且他们认为这就是非常好的节日。
Somebody was asking me.If it was very austere in Mayapur, I said, I think the austerity is to be away from Mayapur.
有人问我，他说在玛雅普生活是不是非常苦行啊？我的回答是，离开了玛雅普的生活太苦行了。
So being in Mayapur, we have nice festivals. Krishna conscious festivals.
因此在马耳普我们有非常好的节日 Krishna 知觉的节日。
And we want Radhisham to create Krishna conscious festivals in her home, in her hometown, Nanning.
我们希望 Radhisham Madhati 能够在她自己的家里能够举办 Krishna 知觉的节日在南宁。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Next.
Yeah.
Next from Harivamsa Prabhu, 顶拜 Guru. 这让我想起了小时候夏天乘凉看到满天星星。我想问的是每个星球都有生物居住对吗？每个星球是有人格的个体灵魂吗？这星球是个体的灵魂能量，但星球的个体灵魂并不一定住在这个星球上对吗？比如地球。A basis to Guru, I want to ask, every star, they have the living entity, is that right? This is the first part.
Yes.
And every star have the personal living entity soul.
Yes.
是的。And all the living entities, those, they live in the end star, but some of them, they are not in this plane. Sati Mataji, 能不能帮一下这最后一个部分是怎么说的？这个星球的个体灵魂能量，但这个星球的个体灵魂并不一定住在这个。
这个星球的个体灵魂不一定在这个星球。
这个星球的个体灵魂并不一定居住在这个星球上，对吗？The souls in our planet are not necessary to live in our planet. Is that right?
Well, they can live on any planet.
它可以，是的，这个星球上的这个灵魂，它可以住在任何的其他的星球上。
Yeah, we have been living in the past on other planets and other places.
或许我们上一世在其他的星球上的其他地方。
We can even come from other universes.
我们甚至也可能是来自于其他的宇宙。
So sometimes we're in the higher planets, heavenly planets, sometimes we're in the hellish planets.
有些时候我们在高等的星球，有些时候我们是在低等的星球。
Now you're here on the earth planet.
现在你在地球。
You have a chance, a very important opportunity to make your life perfect.
你有一个很好的机会，非常重要的机会，能够让你的人生获得完美。
To go back to Godhead this lifetime.
在这一生就能够回归守神。
Possible from this planet.
非常可能的是在这个星球上。
Not so easy from other planets.
不，从别的星球上并不一定那么容易。
So we should be very serious, very careful to become Krishna conscious in this lifetime.
在这一生，因此就得非常的小心，非常的仔细。Next question from Sasanga. Dimbai Guru 的莲花族 Jua Maharaj 住的北极星是我们肉眼能够看得见吗呢？夜往北方有一颗非常亮的星星，人们叫它北极星，说的就是朱瓦洛卡马哈拉吉住的这个北极星吗？ The North Star is visible in our material eyes.
The Pole Star.
Yeah, Pole Star.
Yes.
And this Pole Star is the Jua Maharaj's place.
Yeah, Dhruva Maharaj was put there.
是的，朱瓦马哈拉吉就在我们这个肉眼所看见的这个北极星。
Uh-huh.
So, So we call this poster is the Dhruva Maharaj's place.
Yeah, we call it Dhruva Loka.
Okay. 这个我们称作的北极星就是 Dhruva Maharaj 所住的那个地方，也叫做 Dhruva Loka. Next question from the DQ Surabhi. Surabhi, 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜翻译。最近我听到中国新闻报道，美国和苏联已经到达月球，他们分割月球的正面，中国也进入了月球，也进入了月球，中国占据月球的背面，三国瓜分了月球，准备开发月球，这样是不是毁灭月球啊？影响植物生长也会毁灭人类。A basis to Google. Recently, I listened to the news. China and America and Russian, they go to the Earth plan. Oh, they go to the Moon plan, Moon star. So they are going to do some activities to in the Moon star. So these activities, are they going to destroy the moon star and influence the plants in our plant?
I don't believe they're going to the moon star.
我不相信他们去到了月球。
If they're saying they're going to go there, it's just another trick to get money from the taxpayers.
如果他们声称到了月球，这只是另外一个玩笑，这只是另外一个玩笑，这只是另外一个事情，他们想获得借口，想要获得钱的借口。
It's nearly 50 years since they went to the moon, since they said they went to the moon.
将近五十年前，他们说他们去过月球。
Now they say they're going to go again.
他们现在说准备再去吗
？I don't think it's possible at all.
我一点都不认为这是可能的事情。
To go to the moon, you see, the moon is one of the heavenly planets. So to go there, you have to have pious activities.
去到月球需要要有虔诚活动才行。他们可能去到的是别的星球。
Yeah, the moon and the sun are both heavenly planets.
月球和太阳都是非常高等的星球，去到那里需要有虔诚活动才行。
We see in the Ramayana that Ravana, the demon Ravan, he also wanted to go to the moon.
我们在这个罗摩衍那 Ramayana 中看到这个 Ravana, 他也想去到月球。
He was planning to build a staircase to go there.
他想建立一个天梯去到那里。
But he could never build it. He could never complete it.
但是他无法完成这个事情，不可能完成这个事情。
The same way the demoniac scientists, they're talking about sending the spaceships there, but they can never go there. They can never do anything.
同样的，这些恶魔主义的科学家，他们也无法去到那里。
The last time they tried, they sent.A woman, along with three other men, into space, and they all died.
上一次他们说他们要去的时候，他们派了一个女的和其他三个男的，但是四个人全部死了。
They died, and they were in space for only a few minutes, and the whole thing blew up. The whole thing.
他们在太空中就只待了几分钟，然后就全部燃烧了。
So, we don't put much faith in these words of these scientists.
我们不要花太多的信心在这些科学家上。
There was also Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha, he was always looking for gold, and he would dig up different regions, try to find the gold.
Hiranyaksha, 他总是在寻找黄金，他总是用各种方法去找黄金。
And he dug up so much ground that the earth planet became unstable and fell into the bottom of the universe.
他从地球底下挖了很多的黄金出来，然后这个地球失去了这个重力平衡，掉到了，这个海洋上。
The bottom of the universe.
掉到了这个地球的，掉到了这个宇宙的底端。
Lord Varaha had to come and pick up the earth.
主 Varaha 从这个底下给他举了起来。
And see, when the scientists, when they show the moon, they say it's like a desert. They said, oh, it's just a desert, there's just dust there, nothing there.
当科学家他们展示月球的时候，他们说月球只是一片沙漠，什么都没有。
But Prabhupada says, the Vedas tell us that the moon planet is very tropical, and there's lots of trees and lots of cultivation there. There's a lot of, it's not like a desert at all, but there's many plants and flowers and things.
但圣帕帕德通过伟达经向我们展示，伟达知识展示，在月球上是有很多的植物的，很多的文化，很多的植物，很多的蔬菜在那。
It's opulent because it's a heavenly planet. It's going to be opulent. It's not going to be like a desert.
因为月球是属于高等的星球，它绝对不会是像我们这样所说的是一个沙漠。月既然是高等的星球，那里就一定会很富裕。
The desert is an inauspicious place.
沙漠是一种不吉祥的地方。
No sacrifice is usually performed in the desert.
没有什么，不会有祭祀在这个沙漠上举行。
So people don't know these things. They have no information. They don't understand.
人们不知道这些事情，他们没有这些知识，他们不了解这些。
But we know because we know from the Vedas. We told everything in the Vedas.
但是我们知道这些知识，我们所有的这些知识都是伟达知识告诉给我们的。
Okay. Are you okay?
Yeah. Yes. Last question. From 琪琪 Dimbai Gurudev 风水之类的是半神人的影响力吗？作为主的奉献者，是否根本不需要普通风水吉祥物？Chinese 风水 is similar about Western or astrology. So this astrology is also the influence of the demigod.
中国风水。
风水
is it the influence of the,
yeah,
the demigods?
How to, yeah, how to make everything auspicious?
Yes, but they see that the point is that the Chinese feng shui, it's an atheistic. They don't accept the existence of God. It's atheistic, so it's very materialistic thing.
中国的这个风水实际上因为他们没有接受神，没有接受这个神的概念，所以它还是属于一种物质的能量在这个里面。
So everything is done without any consideration of the Supreme Lord. So this is the difference between the Chinese feng shui and the Vedas. They talk aboutFeng Shui, they talk about it as Vastu. And in the Vedas, Vastu, everything is based around the Supreme Lord.
中国的风水和伟达的这个伟达的星象是不同的。 伟达的星象的一切的知识基源于至尊主在背后的影响。
So feng shui, does it take into account the demigods? No, well, they don't follow the Vedic philosophy. Feng shui has nothing to do with the Vedas, nothing to do with the demigods.
风水和半神人没有什么关系，他不是遵循的伟达的知识在这个里面。
But it's based on their materialistic ideas, materialistic philosophy.
这是物质主义的概念和他们的理论。Then she asked, as the devotees of the Lord, shall we not consider all the 风水 auspicious things?
We depend on Krishna.
我们只是依靠 Krishna 就行。
Right, we said, for a devotee of Krishna, these things are not very important.
对于 Krishna 的奉献者，这一切都不是那么的重要。
But you know, if you're able to follow, if there are some principles of feng shui, if some things are told to you, you can, if you like to follow them, if it's not too much trouble, not too much difficulty, you can do it. No harm.
如果这个风水里面有这么一些的规则让你去遵循，对你没有太多的影响，或者说不打扰你，没有损失的话，你可以去遵循，没有什么坏处。
But the thing is, the feng shui is an atheistic, whole atheistic culture. There's no account of God.
但是这个风水它只是物质的这个事情，它跟神并没有什么关系。
So what you may do in feng shui may be something different in if you do it in Vedic culture.
或许你做的这个风水跟伟达的文化也是不同的。
Maybe, I don't know.
或许我也不是很确定这些事情。
Then you may please one demigod, you may displease others.
你或许取悦了一个半神，但是又没有取悦另外一个人。
You want to please the Supreme Lord, then they're all pleased.
如果你取悦至尊主的话，所有的一切都取悦，都被取悦了。
So when we have a new house, the first thing we do is,We worship Krishna.
当你有一个新家的时候，第一件事情要做的是崇拜 Krishna.
And you have some kirtan, and then you invite the devotees and feed the devotees.
然后你做一个 kirtan 唱诵，你邀请奉献者来给他们大餐。
And all the devotees will bless you, and in this way, your life will be auspicious.
所有的奉献者祝福你。在这之后，你的人生就会变得很吉祥。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Good day. 那个Harivansa他不刚才他的那个问题不是很清楚吗？然后刚刚又问了他，他刚回复，他是想问，就是刚才Guru您不是讲到了像那个地球Bhumi女神，她并不一定居住在地球吗？她可以居住在。任何的地方，他是想问，就是，每一个星球都是有人格的，就是说这个人格的个体灵魂，他是不是不一定都居住在他的自己的这个星球上，就像那个不明女神一样
？Well, Bhumi Nusha, the Mother Earth, the deity, the deity of Mother of this Earth planet, Mother Bhumi.She will certainly stay here, but sometimes she will go other places. Like if there's some problem here, she'll go to see Lord Brahma. And then Lord Brahma will meditate on Lord Vishnu and she will be there with him while he's meditating on Lord Vishnu, right? So sometimes she does go away.
比如说这个Bhumi女神，她虽然是常住在这个地球上的， 但是当地球上如果有什么问题的时候，他去寻求 Brahma 的帮助， Brahma 去找至尊主的时候，他也是会离开这里去找 Brahma， 去到至尊主那里去的。
And of course she is an individual living entity. She's been given this job as Mother Bhumi. And so maybe after some time she may give up this job and she'll be given some other position and some other soul will get that job of being Mother Bhumi.
地球女神 Bhumi 也是一个个体灵，也是一个个体灵魂。有当她在这里完成一段工作的时候，她有可能会放弃她的工作，然后去到别的地方，然后别的个体灵魂来得到这个工作。
Just like somebody, you may get the position of being Yamaraj, and so it's a position. It's not a particular individual living entity. And similarly, Brahma, it's a position. It's not an individual living entity.
就像 Yamaraj 和 Brahma。它只是一个位置，但不是说是一个特定的个体灵，不是一个特定的个体灵魂，不是一定就是那个。
In the past, we may have been Brahma. When we first come into the material world, we may get the position of Brahma.
在过去，我们来到这个物质世界，我们得到第一个职位，有可能就是 Brahma.
And we heard about Yamaraj. Yamaraj got cursed.And he got cursed to become a Sudra, so he had to give up the position of Yamaraj, and someone else has to take his place while he comes into this world. Yamaraj comes as Vidura.
当 Yamaraj, 比如说我们在这个经典中听到 Yamaraj 他被诅咒为成为一个 Sudra, 然后当 Yamaraj 来到这儿成为 Vidura, 成为这个 Sudra 的时候，有别的人代替他的这个职位，承担 Yamaraj 的角色。
But after Vidura, after some time, after the curse was over, then he went back and became Yamaraj again.
当 Yamaraj 这个诅咒结束之后，他又回去当自己的 Yamaraj， 就这个 Vidura 继续回去当 Yamaraj.
But it doesn't mean every time there's creation that he's always Yamaraj.
并不意味着所有的创造的时间都是这个 Yamaraj.
Is that clear, Sandy? Mingbai ma? Sati?
Sati, Mother
Krishna. 我不知道哈瑞邦萨帕布是不是明白了，但是他又接着问了另外一个问题。
有可能去到某一星球，但我们人体眼睛看不到这个星球，居住在这个星球的所有个体灵魂，对吗？比如火里有灵魂，但我们看不到。有可能科学家去到高等星球，但他们看不到高等精卫的生命。高等精卫。Maybe we can go to some plant, but our this body and this eyes cannot see this plant living entity. Is that right?
Cannot see this what?
If we go to another planet, but from our eye, we can't see these plants, the people.
No.
In this, yeah, 不能。Like, for example, in the fire, they also have the soul, but we cannot see.So maybe some of the scientists go to the higher plant, but they cannot see the subtle living entities.
Well, the point is to go to the higher planets, you have to be qualified. You have to have a lot of punya. You cannot just go there by material means.
这个事情的要点是要去到高等的星球，必须要有很多的虔诚活动。而不是说我们去到那里看不到什么星球，我们需要有去到那里需要有虔诚活动才能去到那里。
Yeah, it's the whole universe is designed in such a way that it's not so easy for souls to go, you know, into space and go through the universe into other You can do it if you're very pious. Like Lord Krishna, he can do it. And he can take Arjuna on his chariot and he can go.
这个宇宙就是这么被设计的，不是说你想去到那儿去到那儿，你必须要有一定的虔诚活动才行。就像 Krishna， 他可以去到任何一个地方，他带着 Arjuna 去到那些地方。
And great yogis, sometimes they go in trance. They can do it in their subtle bodies. They can travel to different regions.
还有这些伟这些伟大的玄秘瑜伽师，他们可以以一种精微的方式去到很多其他的地方。
But to go by mechanical means, by building a spaceship, is very unlikely.
但是以一种化学的方式，一种物质的方式，比如说建立一个什么建立一个太空什么样的东西去。并不是很受欢迎和被认可的。
Prabhupada said, maybe they went to Rahu, maybe they went to one. You know, there's a couple of planets in the universe which are invisible, Rahu and Ketu. So he said, maybe they went to Rahu.
就像圣帕帕德之前给我们举的那个例子。这些科学家们有可能去到的只是 Rahu， 因为在宇宙中确实有一些很隐性的这些星球。
嗯 ，OK，OK，、
okay.
okay, 好。我们今天讲到这儿。
好的，好的，
谢谢，
今天已经两个小时多了、
嗯，
我们可以到这里结束了，没有其他问题了。
好。我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听，祝福你们新年快乐。我们希望今年比去年好。我们每年都越来越好。我们如果我们在 Krishna 之间，肯定越来越好。如果没有 Krishna 之间，肯定都是不好。所以感谢苏布里拉给我们翻译，感谢萨提主持。感谢所有的奉献者，祝福你们 ，Hare Krishna， 万事如意，团交顺利
，Hare Krishna，
也祝您，是也祝咕噜新年快乐，跑步新年快乐 ，Hare Krishna，
感谢
大家的聆听
，Hare Krishna。